rejoice that Jesus was born among us. Still more we rejoice that he calls us as we are. So we ask for mercy. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh, fullness of the Father, Lord have mercy.
Lord,
may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We praise our God.
Father, forever, His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. as there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields, keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I proclaim to you good news and great joy. It will be for all the people. For today, in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was a multitude of the heavenly host, with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Came into the world for each and every one of us. who is with us every moment of our lives. All we have to do is open our hearts, and his love will shine within us. In the Gospel of Luke, the shepherds are in the fields, and the angel appears and says something that is stated 365 times in Scripture, one for each day, if you will. Be not afraid. Today a Savior has been born to you in the city of David. Then a multitude of the angels appear, singing, Glory to God in high heaven, peace on earth to those on whom his favor rests. Imagine being those shepherds out in the fields with the heavenly court in their midst, truly a vision of heaven, because the Son of God is born tonight to the world. Be not afraid. Rely on the Spirit of Christ at all times. Christ is with us and will never abandon us, giving us the peace that we need so that we can bring peace to everyone around us. The power of prayer and the power of the Eucharist cannot be emphasized enough. The same Jesus Christ that is born to us tonight is the same Jesus Christ who comes to us in the Eucharist as bread and wine truly become Christ's body and blood, giving us the wisdom and the strength to follow the Lord in our lives. How truly blessed we are to be invited to eat at the Lord's Supper. In the Gospel of John, it states, he was present to God in the beginning. Christ was one in being with the Father for all time, until his Father sent him into the world. And now he sits at the right hand of the Father until he comes again. The light of Christ is the light that no darkness can overcome. Stay close to Christ at all times. Cry out to him when needed. Simply say the name above every other name, Jesus Christ. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in the heavens, on the earth, and under the earth. So John later states, the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us, the glory of an only Son coming from the Father. We celebrate the beauty and splendor of Christmas with great joy and exaltation, because Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, is born to us tonight, is with us, and will never abandon us in our lifetime. May the light and glory of this Christmas night be with us every day of our lives and for all eternity. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
towards that, please. Let us ask for God's blessing on this Christmas manger and upon ourselves, that we can reflect on the birth of Jesus and share in the salvation he accomplished. Bless this crash. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. pray, brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly, for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord and Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, on the feast of this awe-filled mystery, though invisible in his own divine nature, he has appeared visibly in ours, and begotten before all ages. He has begun to exist in time, so that raising up in himself all that was cast down, he might restore unity to all creation. Call straying humanity back to the heavenly kingdom. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Disciples saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, through those sinners, open your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share the fellowship of your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom we continue to make all these good things, O Lord, and sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of peace. O Lamb of God, beholding who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy to be seated at your feet, but I am worthy to say the word.
Thank you.
Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world, born this day, is the author of divine generation for us, so we may be the giver of immortality who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
A couple of announcements. For Christmas and New Year break, the parish office will be closed from December 26th until January 2nd, and the church will be closed from December 26th until December 30th. There will be no masses during that time. No confessions on December 28th. Our regular mass schedule will resume on December 31st. Office hours will resume on January 3rd. We're still looking for a hospital minister for Thursdays. If you're able to help, please contact the Kralichek, see our two-week bulletin for her contact information. On behalf of all the staff, I wish all of you a very Merry Christmas, filled with the joy and peace of our Lord. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
God bless the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.